Everyone, hope you all are well. So the first thing I'm doing is priming the eye area, and to do that I'm using the Zoeva Eyeshadow Fix. I've just picked up a little of this on my Sigma 3D HD Precision Brush, and I'm patting this all over the eye area. And what I really like about this brush is the shape of it. It allows me to just get into all the nooks and crannies around the eye. My palette of choice today then is the Zoeva Smoky palette. It's one of my favourite cool toned eyeshadow palettes. It just has a lovely selection of shades ranging from matte shimmers. And the first shade I'm taking is called Sleep to Dream. This is a lovely grey shadow that has an almost lilac undertone to it. And I've just picked up some of this on a Coastal Scents blending brush. And I'm starting by working this into the crease of the eye. So I'm just using circular motions, just running it back and forward in the crease, followed by then little windshield wiper motions. And between these two motions, it helps to just give me a really nice blend to that shadow. And then the less product that I have on my brush, the higher then I'm going to raise my brush up towards the brow bone, and this will just give me a really nice fade. I'm also then going for a spotlight eye today. So what I'm doing now is I'm reapplying this shade, adding a second layer, adding it into the crease, and then I'm dropping it down onto the inner and outer corners of the eye. Next then I'm taking a Sigma pencil brush, and I've just picked up some more of that grey shade, and now I'm sweeping it down along the lower lash line. So I've started from the outer corner of the eye, made my way across to the inner portion of the eye, and then I'm just making sure that it connects up on that outer edge. The next shadow I'm taking is called Elegant Chaos. It's that gorgeous deep purple. And I'm using this on a smaller brush. This one is the Sedona Lace EB09. Basically what I'm doing now is just popping that colour into the crease, into the deepest part of the crease, and I'm using little circular motions, and I'm wriggling this colour all the way across into the crease to add some depth. So initially I'm keeping it very deep into the crease, and again, as I've got less product on my brush, I'm going to fade it up then towards the brow bone. What I'm going to do then is pick up a second layer of this shadow. Like I did with the grey, I'm then patting it down on the inner and outer portion of the eyelid, and then I'm connecting it across into the crease. And I'm just repeating this process a couple of times until I'm happy with the intensity and the blend of the shadow. I want no harsh lines. Next then, I'm taking that same pencil brush with a little more of that purple. And I'm starting by wriggling this along the lower lash line right into the roots of the lashes. Now I'm going to build up this purple in a couple of light layers. So once I've kind of got the bulk of the product off my brush now, I'm then going in again and I'm reapplying it. And my eyes are quite sensitive and can tend to water quite a bit. So I just make sure to blink as frequently as I can, and that stops them watering. As silly as it sounds, it works. Then I'm also taking that purple, just whatever's left on the brush, down onto the inner and outer portion of the eye and into the crease. And a smaller brush just allows me to get deep into those areas, and it'll just pack more of a punch too because the brush is more dense. Then I faded everything out with a blending brush. Now I'm patting some of the shade Searching down on the centre of the lid, and I'm not cutting the crease with a concealer or anything like that. I've spritzed a little bit of a setting spray onto the brush after I picked up some shadow, and then I'm just using the shadow itself and the fact that it's wet just to carve out that center portion of the lid. So I'm just again adding a couple of light layers like I always do to build up the intensity, and just to make sure that I'm happy then with the color payoff and the blend. To add an extra bit of depth then, I'm taking the shade Real Light, and this is just a matte black. I'm using that same pencil brush now just to dust some of the shadow on the inner and outer portion of the eye, and I'm sweeping it across into the center of the lid, just overlapping it with that silver shade to make sure it fades nicely in with the rest of the shadows. Then I'm using an angled brush, which is just going to help me be a little bit more precise. It's going to help me carve out that crease area. And I'm just applying this on the very edge of that silver just to define that spotlight shape that I've got going on there. I'm also then using that black along the upper lash line again, just to add a bit of depth and fullness to my lashes there. And once I'm happy then with how that looks, I'm switching to the lower lash line. And again, I'm just patting this down, wriggling it in at the lash bed, and I'm bringing it from the outer corner all the way across into the inner corner of the eye. To line the waterline then, I'm using a cake liner from KVD Beauty, and it's a retractable one, which I really like, and I'm just closing my eye around the pencil so that I line both upper and lower waterline. For lashes then, I've done something different. This is actually a liner glue pen by Kiss, so I'm just lining along the upper lash line with this first, and then quite simply then I just stick my lashes on top of this, and yeah, it's just really handy. So the lashes I've used are from Eylure, and then to blend my own lashes in with the false ones, I'm taking the Lancome Lashy Doll mascara. It's got a nice curve to it, so it gives a really nice lift to the lashes. I'm applying this to my bottom lashes, and then I'm going to apply it to the top lashes too, and that'll help blend my own ones in with the false ones. But then that's it. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and found it helpful and easy to follow. If you did, please let me know, and I'll catch you all in a video really soon.